My name is Diane, and I am an alcoholic. My name is Diane Cunningham, and I am the founder and president of the National Association of Christian Women Entrepreneurs. This is my story that I'm going to be telling you today. This is my testimony. This is the journey that I have walked on that I want to share with you, because by sharing it, I might set you free. By sharing it, I am setting myself free even more than I've already been given the freedom of the sobriety that I have right now. And what I have found over these last few months is that rock bottom is a beautiful place. And as a now single, sassy, and sober Christian woman, I have nothing left to hide anymore. And I'm standing up. I am moving forward, and I want to share my story with you today because I want you to do the same thing. You might be wondering how I ended up in this place, and I've really thought a lot about that. Over the course of my journey, during my life, I have walked through a lot of things. My story includes walking through depression in my teen years and in my 20s. I've had an eating disorder. I walked through that, and in the last couple years, I walked through the ending of my 10-year marriage. I went through what feels like a death when your marriage ends. So I've been through divorce. Back in 1999, I walked through the lawsuit and a suicide of my client, and because of that, then a lawsuit where I ended up losing my counseling license. I've also been through the journey of infertility and wanting to have children. Never in my wildest dreams did I think I would be in my 40s, in my early 40s, and be divorced with no children. All I have is a cat. My cat is part of my new, the family that I have. And did I think my life was going to turn out like this? No. But guess what? I am right where I'm supposed to be today. And in June of 2013, I was right where I was supposed to be when I hit rock bottom. You never know when you're going to hit rock bottom. Struggle with an addiction, which I didn't really think I had a problem. I teetered, I wondered, I played around with it, but really I was a pre-functional alcoholic. And my business was running, I had a normal life, whatever normal is, and I was on a vacation actually with my family, my parents and my sisters and my nieces and nephews and brothers-in-law, all the people that are in my world, my family. And I was with them in California on my rock bottom week, because I actually hit rock bottom. I'm good. I mean, I might as well do it twice. I hit rock bottom two days that week, and because I like to really go for it if I'm going to do something. And so the last day of my rock bottom day was June 18th of 2013. That rock bottom day changed me, because I don't ever want to feel that humiliation, that shame, that disgust with myself ever again, because other people got to see it, people I love got to see it, but more importantly, I knew that I was not living lined up with God's purpose and who I am. I was living a double life. And if you're living a double life, I know you hear me right now, because it's exhausting. It's exhausting to pretend. It's exhausting to hide. It's exhausting to keep a piece of you hidden because you're afraid everybody's gonna find out. And I'm going to speak directly to you that are listening, because that could be that your marriage is really in shambles. It could be that you struggle with an addiction as well, like I have. It could be that your finances are not what you think everybody else's are, and you're struggling with a huge amount of debt and taking on more. It could be that you have an eating disorder, or that you are dealing with depression, but you don't want anybody to know those things. Coming out of this is that it's time to stop hiding. It's time for you to look at your pain, your thing, the thing that you're afraid everybody's going to see. I'm going to challenge you to look at it. And I'm going to challenge you to stop hiding underneath it, around it, beside it, and set yourself free. As a Christian and as a woman and as the founder of the National Association of Christian Women Entrepreneurs, you can imagine that sharing this message is very, very risky. And I know that. And I know that I most likely am going to lose some followers, fans, members. And I've had to be okay with that in order to share this today. I know that God is a God of grace, and I know that the things that I have walked through in my journey, the alcohol addiction, the depression, the divorce, everything that I have walked through, that I have been forgiven, and that the company that I have created is the company that I believe in not judging other people. I don't know where you are in your journey. I don't know what you have walked through, but I know you've walked through a lot. We all have a story, and it's not my job to judge anybody. Because you know what? I don't want you to judge me. You never know what's going on in the house next door to you. There are broken hearts walking down the street every day. You see them. And you know what? Most of the time, we look the other way. And I looked like I had it all together. And you know what? In many ways, I do have it all together. And in many ways, I'm a broken, wounded child. But you know what? I'm a child of God. And God is the one that is relieving me and has given me this freedom from the addiction. I could not be here talking to you about this, and I would not. I would not be here talking to you about this if I didn't feel compelled and urged by my father to share this message. He told me just a very short time after I got sober that this message is for you to share. Thus, I am here. I am being obedient to what I believe is a story that is going to change not just my life, but the lives of those that get to hear it. So again, I want you just to remember that I'm Diane. And I am an alcoholic, and I'm sober, and I am sassy, and I'm pretty spunky, and I'm here if you need to talk to me. I'm here if you want to connect with me. I am here if you have a question to ask me. And as you can tell, I'm pretty open. I'm willing, I'm open, and I'm ready to do what God has called me to do. In fact, that was my prayer this morning before I recorded this, is that whatever needs to be said would be said. Because this is my story. I'm not making this up. This is not fiction. This is reality. And reality isn't pretty. It's dark, doggone messy, actually. And so if you want to talk about your messy experience or your messy life or your journey to become more you, I would love to connect with you. You can find me on social media. You can find me on my website, nacwe.org, and let me know how I can support you, love you, and encourage you.